mathematicians have been really pleased with how much maths we've managed to present to an unsuspecting public.
This is the first time the Ashmolean Museum has engaged with such a concept as maths. The Ashmolean is the university museum, and I think that bringing in researchers from the entire spectrum of the university is very important.
We're always looking for opportunities to reach an audience that might not necessarily be interested in maths.
We initially involved Professor Marcus Dusatoy from the Mathematical Institute, who was responsible at the beginning of putting together a team of mathematicians. He was very interested in exploring the concept of symmetries, and it was only when realizing we wanted to do something involving two dimensions and three dimensions that the concept of exploring the very idea of dimensions came up.
We wanted to tie the idea of dimensions in with both the art world but also with our everyday research.
As we selected the pieces, I would take out a tile and explain to him that it was a 16th century Turkish tile. And Josh would look at it and say, ah, interesting. It's clearly an example of reflection.
I think the virtual reality was really crucial to the exhibition. There were four of us involved in actually coding up the VR app. We were all doctoral students in the Wolfson Centre for Mathematical Biology. It really brings a way of representing mathematical objects that can't exist in our normal three-dimensional world. I also think it's just really cool to go zooming around inside a mega sponge or inside a fractal shape.
We had people who said, I think I'm getting there, but I haven't quite understood. I will be back. And at the same time, we had a lot of people with a mathematical background who came quite surprised at the exhibition and left really amazed that the maths was such as to challenge their own understanding of it.
People come to the Ashmolean to engage with history, to engage with art, and I think it was really exciting to see those same people really enjoying engaging with maths through those mediums. I think a lot of the time, the things that humans tend to perceive as being beautiful tend to have some underlying mathematical basis that we maybe aren't conscious of.
One of the key elements and successes of this exhibition has been challenging people's preconceptions of what they thought a concept of dimension was, almost tricking them into learning a bit more about these mathematical concepts and doing that through art.